whether I think it's worth it or not. You know, why should you spend the extra money for one of these bongs, you know, one of these, when you can get a bong for pretty much like a fraction of the price? What is the fucking difference? A lot of you guys ask me this.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place.
What's up, OGs? Welcome back, and if you're new here, welcome. It's been a while since we filmed one of these videos. So today's video, high-end glass, is it worth it? Expensive glass, top dollar glass, whatever you want to call it. We're not going to be talking about dab rigs for this video. It's really just going to be centered towards bongs, like high-end glass bongs. We got a Sovereignty right here. It's actually loaded up with some Kush mints right now, so let's fucking take a hit. Let's get high first. Cheers. That's one of those rips where the coughs are gonna come in late. It's not fun trying to talk when your lungs haven't recovered and like right now. And yo, before we get into the topic of the video, I just wanted to say real quick, I've been going live on Twitch pretty much every night. If I don't go live every night, then it's every other day. I say night because I've been starting my streams pretty fucking late, around like 8:30, 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. But follow the Twitch if you guys are down. Twitch link will be in the description if you guys fuck with the Twitch and the live streams, you know. Just letting you know, it gets lit in there.
Fucking scrub. Get got.
So now, high-end glass. I'll just say this. I'm not someone that has a whole bunch of fucking high-end glass bongs. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which I would consider, like, high-end, you know. Some, you know, made from a good glass artist. We'll get into all that. So there's... I just want to get that out of the way because there's might be some people who are watching this who have been collecting glass for way longer than me, have a way bigger collection, and I don't want to come across like I know it all or I'm just, you know, I'm just kind of giving my opinion on high-end glass and if it's worth it for you, in my opinion. And I'll just say it for the most part, it is. It honestly depends on what type of smoker you are. I'll get into all that, but yeah, I'll show you guys all the pieces I currently have. So I have a Sovereignty 50x5. I think they're all, like, pretty much all mine are, well, besides one of them are 50x5s, but this is a 3-line. These ones are really nice. They have, they stack really good. If you saw me, this is the one I took the hit in the beginning. It has that nice bubble stackage. And yeah, I normally don't start my videos off with a... I mean, it's not that dirty. I normally try and start it off fresh clean, but it's okay, because we got one here. So we'll take a hit out of this in a little bit, but... Here's my 180 grid. It's a 50x5 as well by Sovereignty, and I know the bowl doesn't match it. I actually have been using these Jared Bennett bowls that my homie Luke Fondelberg has been putting me on. He actually sells these, so if you guys... think these bowls are fucking cool. They're really fucking nice. They're four hold slides. They're blown by Jared Bennett. What Luke does is he gets them in bulk orders and pretty much sells them on his Instagram. They fucking go bulk. So I'll put his Instagram up and just be on the lookout for them if that's what you want to look for. You know, he'll post it on his story or he'll post it on his regular Instagram. And just for reference, so you guys know, the normal bowls that actually come with these Sovereignty pieces. So this blue one right here would go Let me just put it on here with this one. There we go. And you can see it matches a lot better, and you're probably wondering, well, why don't you use that bowl? I mean, I do sometimes. I switch them all out. I just really like... You can see they're pretty similar, but the size of this one and the shape of it, I honestly like it a little more, and I've been... Ever since I started smoking out of the Jared Bennett bowls, I kind of find myself smoking out of the actual bowl, the Sovereignty bowls that come with it less. Not to say that they're fucking... Dude, like, these bowls are massive. I can pretty much fit my thumb in here. You can fit a fuck ton of weed in here. And then pretty much the same thing. This is the technically the one that would come with this. It's just a fucking clear slide. But yeah. And I have a few more pieces on the shelf. I'll show you guys those. But I don't want this to seem like a sponsored video for Sovereignty Glass or any of these. Because it's really not. It's just my opinion on whether I think it's worth it or not. You know, why should you spend the extra money for one of these bongs, you know, one of these, when you can get a bong for pretty much like a fraction of the price? What is the fucking difference? A lot of you guys ask me this. So the difference between like a cheap bong, like a China glass bong, and an American made, you know, and not to say that all American made glass is good, but you know, by a nice reputable company or artist, you know, what is the difference between that and China glass? So I'm not an expert on how China glass is produced, but I know it's mass produced and the type of glass that they use is not the fucking same. It's way cheaper and it fucking breaks easier. I think most American made glass is made with borosilicate, or it might be, I don't know. See, that's the thing. I don't want to fucking act like I know everything because I really don't. I know it's made out of fucking better glass, though. So that's just, like, durability factors. It's going to be more durable. It's not going to break as easier. It's just, you know, going to be put together better, if that makes sense. Now, as far as, like, function goes, like a piece, when you hit it, like, how does it hit, you know, like... Most different pieces, you know what I'm saying, have a different function. So, most China glass, in my experience, and here's the thing, I've smoked out of so much China glass. A lot of the glass that I've smoked on, actually, on this fucking channel, a lot of older videos, have been China glass. And I'm not here to hate on it, I'm just to kind of explain the differences between high-end glass and China glass. So, like, the function on a lot of China pieces, and it's hard because there's... It's not like you say China piece and it's just one function. There's so many different types of bongs, and just to kind of sum it up, the function is not really going to be as good as something that you're paying more money for. And it's kind of like you get what you pay for, and I know that's not really a good way of explaining it, but just think of it this way. There's artists who spend hours of their time, you know, trying to master, and I'm just holding this because... You know, Steve from Sovereignty Glass, he's a fucking beast. But they spend hours of their time and work trying to master a function and make something hit right. And not only that, it's like the artistic factor. A lot of, like, these bowls and the colors and the different things they use to make these things are, like, it costs more, it takes more fucking time. If you could imagine something getting, like, mass-produced in a factory that doesn't really have that much value to it versus, like, an artist that's making something and they spent a lot of time working on it. And not only that, a lot of these functions that they got with these bongs, they have got them down to the fucking T. And I'm talking from most high-end glass. In my experience, I really like Sovereignty, obviously. I like Toro, Seed of Life. I have a Seed of Life right here. The joint, unfortunately, is chipped right now, but, I'm supposed to get that repaired sometime soon. It's really been my call, and I've been lagging on it, but, yeah, luckily it's not too bad of a chip, but Seed of Life. And there's a lot of more others. There's a Symbiotic. I don't own one of those, but, the homie Luke, who I was talking about earlier, has one of those. And they're a really nice fucking piece. So we basically, like, broke down the difference between China glass and high-end glass to the best of my fucking ability. You know, China glass is pretty much mass-produced. There's not a lot of care that goes to it. Most Chinese companies are, when they're mass-producing shit, they're copying a lot of artists. They're looking at the designs where people are spending a lot of time to make these functions and come up with, you know, good designs and functions and whatnot. They're copying those and kind of making shittier versions of them, you know, like I've seen. That's why there's a lot of fake Toros and fake, you know, just different types of Chinese companies trying to fake what the good bong actually is. And I know it seems like I'm hating on China Glass a lot, but that's really not the case. Now the next thing I'm gonna get into, which is it really breaks down to what type of stoner or what type of smoker are you. In the meantime, I'm gonna take a hit really quick. Only one rip in, I'm already faded, but we can get up there more. So this is a fucking, yeah, this is the 180 grid. I really like the blue on, this little horn here. I would just say, I think the fucking 180 grids are underrated. I don't see too many people with them. I feel like a lot of people prefer other different types of functions as far as when it comes to sovereignty, but I really fucking like this shit. I like how the water or the function kind of like recycles itself, you know. It has a really nice function. The water kind of like tumbles. It's like, I love it. And all the 180 grids hit like that. I actually have another. Most people probably think I'm weird for having two bongs of the same function, but this one's just red. The horn is red, and I bought that piece. This one that I just grabbed, the red one, from Luke a little while ago. Well, it was actually quite a, like maybe a year and a half ago, a year ago. So the whole question of this video is it worth it? And like I said earlier, it is, but it kind of depends. Like in most circumstances, I think yes, but in some, no, you know? And here's what I kind of mean by that. You know, there's so many different ways you can smoke weed. There's a lot of different people who mainly smoke joints or mainly smoke blunts or they fucking mainly dab or bong, you know what I'm saying, or it's a mix between. There's so many different ways that you can smoke. There's like a whole bunch of different types of stoners and ways you can smoke. Me, for example, most of you guys know, I'm one of those fucking stoners that mainly takes bong hits. I love to take bong rips. That's just been one of my favorite ways and preferred ways of smoking for the past few years. Not to say that I don't smoke blunts or joints or take dabs, but it seems to me 90% of the time when I'm going to smoke, I'm loading up one of my fucking bowls. So I would definitely fall under the category of a stoner that smokes out of bongs. So what I'm getting at is, if you can relate, if you're one of those stoners that has a bong and that's just how you smoke, like you're into bongs and shit like that, and different functions and shit like that of nice glass interest you, then yeah, I would consider you someone that it would be worth it, you know? Like, it would be an investment. You already smoke out of bongs all the time. Get something fucking nice. If you're already smoking some fire weed, you get some good-ass shit. To me, it'd be kind of silly to get some good-ass, you know, get some good weed and then smoke it out of something poopy. You know what I'm saying? And that's, I'm not hating on anyone who has a fucking lower end piece, and you know, and I brought this thing too because I just wanted to say it's super fucking dirty. I'm not hitting it. This actually stays in my brother's room. I've been letting him fucking hit it, and he doesn't keep his bongs clean like me, you know. Everyone's different, but that's a bong that I paid, I think, like $90, $100, so it's still kind of on the, you know, compared to these are like 300, 500 plus, you know, sovereignties at least. Depending, well, not 300, that's like one that's going to be clear, you know, when you have colors on it and shit, it's going to be more expensive. But either way, like, you can, like, what I'm trying to say is you don't got to break your bank, you know. I think like $90, $100 is really not that bad for like a good ass bong, you know. You guys know I fucking love beakers, a piece like this. I believe the Raw OG beaker from Daily High Club is around the same class, around the same price, but, you know. And then obviously every stoner doesn't just smoke like me, and not everyone just mainly takes bong ribs. There's a lot of people who fucking mainly smoke fucking joints or mainly dab and whatnot. So if you're one of those people that just kind of like, you don't really care as much about your weed, you just kind of like smoke to get high, you just have a piece and you just like go and hit it, you don't really even care to clean it, it's just like kind of there, you don't really like think too much about glass. I'm just like trying to think of like different people I know, because there's so many different types of stoners, you know. Let's say you roll a lot of blunts or you roll a lot of joints, and or it's just something you really don't care about. Like, you just really, just plain and simple, some people just don't give a fuck about like the function of a bong. Some people just want to smoke to get high. Then it probably wouldn't be worth it. It wouldn't be worth it for you in that case. If you really just don't give a shit. And that's not to say that you have to, it's either you give a shit or you don't give a shit. It's just really a matter of what type of stoner are you. There's no hate at all. There's like, if you're someone that mainly smokes blunts or mainly smokes joints, then I don't see the point in you spending money on getting a bong if you really like not into it. It's like, if you're into smoking bongs, if you like the function of it, it's like one of your favorite ways to smoke, look at it as an investment. It's kind of like breaking it down like that. So for the most part, a lot of you stoners who, I feel like a lot of you guys who watch my channel, a lot of you guys like to hit bongs and shit like this. So in that case, yes, like I think investing in a nice piece of glass, you know, it is worth it, you know, if you're that type of stoner. So yeah, that's pretty much it. It really comes down to what type of stoner are you, you know. China glass isn't all that bad. It fucking does the job. It clearly does. It's fucking sold probably more than high-end glass. But yeah, so let me show you guys the few other pieces that I fucking have, just because I was showing you guys the pieces that I fucking have, and I think we've pretty much broke it down, you know, the difference between China glass and high-end glass and if it's worth it or not, you know. Oh, it's a little dirty. I need to clean it. It's not too bad though. So this is the Stem to Imperial. I'm sure a lot of you guys recognize this piece. It's been on the channel since I got it. I'm pretty sure I did a video on it, like, right when I got it. This is my first Sovereignty, I think? And then here's the Seed of Life I was talking about. Unfortunately, it's chipped right here. But luckily, I know a glass artist that said that he could try and repair it for me. You know, no promises, but I feel like chances are he'd probably be able to do it, you know. The piece, luckily, actually still functions. It doesn't, like, the airflow is still perfect. It's just kind of sketchy. Not really when it comes to smoking it. Like, I'm not gonna accidentally cut myself, like, knock on wood. That could be fucking bad. But it really comes to cleaning your piece, because I clean my glass a lot. Like, you know, you'd have to, like, grip this and put your finger on, like, a broken fucking chip. I mean, it's obviously not smart. And then the one last thing that I could think of that is a lot of you guys are probably going to be asking, like, where can I get this type of glass? So me personally, you guys know I live in Las Vegas. If you don't, well, now you do. I get mine at Gorilla Radio. This isn't even a sponsored video at all whatsoever. I pay for all my glass, but Gorilla Radio is in my opinion, it's like the best smoke shop here in Vegas. They carry all the fucking good shit. They get the Sovereignty drops, and they have all the fucking heady rigs from all the different crazy artists. Voorhees, fucking Rhino, you know, if you're familiar with them, you know, it's one of the better shops, you know. It's not a shitty shop. Then obviously all you guys don't fucking live in Las Vegas. What I would really do is just try and find, depending where you fucking live, you can get them online. You can go on Instagram and go and try and find, like, different people auctioning them. But I'll just say this, be careful. You might get fucking taxed. You might have someone trying to flip a piece and, like, get over on you. So fucking be careful on that. A lot of people do raffles and fucking just buy shit to flip it. And the whole fucking, at least for Sovereignty, the game, it's getting kind of fucking weird. But like, the number one thing I would recommend to do is just go try and find, like, a good, like, the best smoke shop in your area, and like that has, like, reputable glass, you know what I'm saying, like, or heady glass from different artists. I don't know, like, not a shop that, like, only carries China glass and, like, you know, stupid shit like that, you know. One last rip. I barely have any weed left in the grinder, but it'll do. Hit the 180. Alright, you guys. Much love. Thank you guys for watching the video. Especially if you got to this point. Peace out.